Great to see you, everyone. Bobby Broyles here along with Rob Washburn for CA Hoops Weekly, powered by Under Armour. Rob, it's not even March yet, and the madness has already begun with so many exciting finishes this past week. It looks like it is a sign for things to come.
Yeah, 4 of the 9 games last week decided by 6 points or less, including that dramatic 34-foot game winner at the buzzer by Hofstra's Justin Wright Horman, which capped a career-high 42-point performance in the Pride 75-72 victory over Northeastern. Hofstra's now the only unbeaten team in CA play at 3-0, and they're currently riding a 10-game winning streak, which is the 4th longest in the nation. Right on the Pride's heels at 3-1 are William & Mary, which picked up a victory at Drexel last Saturday in Delaware, which beat the Tribe and Elon to extend their winning streak to 3 as the Hens are off to their best CA start since 2014. UNCW made a big jump in the standings in impressive fashion, sweeping a pair of CAA road games at James Madison and Towson. The Dukes bounced back from that tough loss and earned their first conference win over Charleston on Saturday, ending the Cougars' 10-game winning streak. The conference season is only 2 weeks old, and every team has at least one CAA win. It's shaping up to be a fun year with plenty of unpredictable outcomes.
4 of the top 5 teams in the CAA standings will battle it out on Thursday night. We begin in Williamsburg as Hofstra will take on William & Mary at 7 on CA.TV. These two teams usually light up that scoreboard a few times a year, Rob, when they meet.
Yeah, even though these teams aren't close geographically, this has developed into one of the great rivalries in the CAA because of the success of both squads and the number of dramatic finishes that have occurred in recent years. As you said, it usually involves a wide open game with plenty of points being scored. But while there's plenty of offensive firepower on both sides, defense is a big reason these teams are at the top of the CAA standings. Both teams are allowing just over 64 points per game in CAA play. Hofstra is number 1 in field goal percentage defense, while William & Mary is number 1 in 3-point defense. Now, all that being said, this game still features 4 of the conference's most potent scorers, with the Pride's Justin Wright Foreman and Elon Pemberton, and the Tribe's Nathan Knight and Justin Pierce. So don't look for this game to be played in the 60s, but for the first time in recent memory, whichever team can continue that success defensively could come out on top.
Also on Thursday night at 7 on CA.TV, two teams that went a perfect 2-0 last week will meet in Wilmington as UNCW hosts Delaware.
Yeah, with all of the craziness we've already talked about, these were the only two teams to go 2-0 last week, and it was really impressive. Yep. UNCW overcame deficits late in regulation and in both overtimes to get past JMU last Thursday, and then held off a late Towson charge on Saturday to sweep a CA road swing for the first time since late in the 2017 season. Now, Devontae Kaycock recorded back-to-back double-doubles to increase his total to 10 for the season. Newcomer Gene Talsilla poured in a season-high 24 points against the Dukes, and freshman point guard Kai Taves dished out 21 assists in the two contests. This is a team that's much deeper than a year ago and has a variety of weapons. Now, Delaware erased a double-digit second-half deficit to edge William & Mary by 2 last Thursday, and then continued the momentum against Elon on Saturday to extend their winning streak to 3 after opening CAA play with that 45-point loss at Hofstra. Similar to the Seahawks, the Hens have a double-double machine in the post in senior Eric Carter, and last year's CAA Rookie of the Year Ryan Allen is rounding into form after suffering a broken foot in the preseason, averaging 15 points per game last week while draining 8 threes. Delaware is also a team with a lot of guys who can score the ball, and this should be a really competitive game on Thursday.
Yep. Moving on to Saturday at 4 on CA.TV, the Tribe will conclude a tough pair of home games this week as Northeastern comes to town.
Yeah, it doesn't get any easier for William & Mary as it goes from facing the team in first place on Thursday to meeting the league's preseason favorite on Saturday. Now, the Huskies' record doesn't look great, but keep in mind their two CAA losses came in overtime to Delaware and on that 3-pointer at the buzzer last Saturday at Hofstra, so they could easily be 3-0. Northeastern finally has its two All-CAA guards, Vasa Pushica and Sean Osius, healthy and in the starting lineup, and both scored in double figures against the Pride. In the absence of their top two players, versatile guard Bolden Brace and post presence Anthony Green are having strong seasons, and the Huskies have gotten a big lift from the addition of guard Jordan Rowland, who's averaging a team-high 15.5 points per game and is among league leaders with 47 three-pointers. Now, we talked earlier about William & Mary's improved defense, but this is a squad that is still dangerous offensively. The Tribe has their own three-point threat in junior Matt Milan, who is 17 of 35 from beyond the arc over the past 4 games and is averaging 17 points per contest over that stretch.
Also at 4 on Saturday on CA.TV, Delaware conclude their southern road swing at the College of Charleston.
Yeah, Charleston faced the difficult task of opening CAA play with 3 straight road games, and it might have caught up to them in a 69-58 setback at JMU last Saturday, where they made a nice rally after falling behind by 17 at the half, but couldn't get over the hump. Now the Cougars get to return to TD Arena, where they have the nation's second longest home winning streak and haven't lost in nearly 2 years. Charleston continues to get great play and great leadership from the dynamic duo of Grant Riller and Jarrell Brantley, who are both shooting better than 50% from the floor and are averaging a combined 42 points per game. However, Charleston's also getting contributions from a variety of other guys, whether it's Brevin Galloway, Jalen McManus, Nick Harris, or last Saturday, freshman Jalen Richard, who contributed a career-high 15 points in just 15 minutes off the bench. This is a team that will continue to improve as roles get defined. Now, we've already talked about the improvement Delaware has made offensively this season, but this team has also been solid on defense. During their three-game CAA win streak, the Blue Hens have held foes to less than 44% shooting from the floor, including 31.6% from three. They will need to maintain that effort on Saturday to try and slow down the Cougars.
Yep, especially at home. Very tough team. Now, here's a look at the rest of the upcoming action around CAA men's basketball.
What does it mean to be a CAA student athlete? It's passion, commitment, accountability, preparing for the real world, discipline, on the court and in the classroom. CAA Hoops. It's only for those who want it the most.
CASports.com will have all the information you need regarding links to live stats, video, and audio coverage. Also, fans, you can watch all of the CA.TV action on several devices such as Roku, Amazon Fire, Apple TV, and Android TV by downloading the CA.TV app that is available now.
You can also continue to follow League on Facebook and Instagram by searching CA Sports. We're also on Twitter, at CA Basketball, using the hashtag CA Hoops.
The CA Hoops on Campus crew will be at Elon this weekend. Continue to follow all of our social media outlets for all the behind-the-scenes action. And remember to tune in next Friday for an In Focus feature on the Phoenix.
Yeah, we're making our first trip this weekend, and we're looking forward to sitting down with senior forward Tyler Sebring and also checking out the new Shar Center.
That is it from us today. Enjoy the games, everyone.